Hello students, in this video we will solve problems based on the exercise 2.5 of polynomial chapter class 9, and we are on question 10. It says factorize the following, and the first problem is 27y cube plus 125z cube. So this is of the a cube plus b cube form. We'll just write down what is the identity first. So what is a cube plus b cube? It is a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. So from here we have to get it into this form, but first we need to find the cubes. So 27, if we factorize, what do we get? 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 9, 3 1s are 3. So 27y cube can be written as 3y the whole cube. Okay. And what about 125? So if you factorize, we get 5 2s are 10, 5 5s are 25, 5 5s are 25, 5 1s are 5. So this can be written as 5z the whole cube. So now it is in the a cube plus b cube form. And we expand this, so we can write this as a plus b into, we'll write a bigger bracket here, into a square minus a into b plus b square, that is 5z whole square. And we put close the bracket. Now we expand. So 3y plus 5z into 3y whole square, can we get as a 9y square minus 3y into 5z gives us minus 15yz, and plus 5z square can be written as plus 5 plus 25z square. So this is our answer. Let's solve another one. The next problem is 64m cube minus 343n cube. First we need to find factors of 64 and 343. So 64 can be written as 2 into 32, 2 into 16, 2 into 8, 2 into 4, 2 into 2, and here, so we have got pairs of triplets basically of 2. So 2 2s are 4, so that means we can write this as 4m whole cube minus 343. See, it goes in 7 times table. 7 4s are 28, carry 6 6 3 7 9 is 63, 7 7 is 1. Okay, so we can write this as 7m whole cube. So now this is a cube minus b cube form. What is the a cube minus b cube? A cube minus b cube can be written as a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. Okay, so first we write a minus b, so a minus b, where a is 4m and b is minus 7m, and a is square, so a bigger bracket over here, 4m whole square, this properly, that is a square plus ab, so plus a into b and plus b square, 7m whole square, and we close the bracket. So b, 4m minus 7m into 4m whole square is 16m square. 4m into this is 7, everywhere this is n, sorry about that, we change it to n, wherever there is m with 7, that's n, and this is also n. Okay, we've covered everywhere n. Yes, so that would be 4m into 7n, which is 28 plus 28 m n, and plus 7n whole square is plus 49 n square. This is our answer to the second. Okay, so we, with that we finish solving question 10. Let's move to question 14.
Question 14 says, without actually calculating the cubes, find the value of each of the following. And the first problem given to us is minus 12 whole cube plus 7 cube plus 5 cube. So what we do is, we take, let A equal to minus 12, B equal to 7, and C equal to 5. Okay, then we apply our identity, which says A cube plus B cube. We say we know, or basically we will write that we know that A cube plus B cube plus C cube is equal to 3ABC. This is our identity. So all we need to do is we need to put this in this particular value. So we need to find the cubes of this. If A is equal to minus 12, so what is A cube? A cube will be minus 12 whole cube, and B cube will be, B is 7, so that would be plus 7 whole cube, and C is plus 5. So we put plus 5 whole cube. So that is exactly what we need to find, minus 12 cube plus 7 cube plus 5 cube. And this thing will be equal to 3 into A. A is what? Minus 12. B is what? 7. And C is 5. So all we need to do is, we need to find the value of this. So let us do that. So minus 12 into 5 is 60. Okay, and 60 into 7 is 420. And 420 into 3 we need to find out. 3 0 6 12. So that will come to minus 1 2 6 0, and that is the answer. So without actually cubing them, we were able to find the answer. Okay, this is a neat trick that we can always use to find out cubes. Where we have three numbers, we can use this identity to find the answer without actually finding the cubes. Okay, let's solve another one. Next problem is 28 cube plus 15 minus 15 cube plus minus 30 cube. Once again, what we do over here is we assume let A equal to 28, B equal to minus 15, C equal to minus 13. Okay, now we know that, write it once again, we know that A cube plus B cube plus C cube equal to 3ABC. This is from our identity. And we'll write down what is A cube now. A cube can be written as 28 cube, and B cube can be written as plus minus 15 whole cube, and C cube can be written as minus 13 whole cube equal to, you can write this. Now this is comparable to our question and also comparable to the identity, which means we need to write the right hand side, which is 3ABC. So A is 28, B is minus 15, and C is minus 13. Okay, so this will become equal to, we will have to just calculate or multiply and find out what the answer will be. We take 28 into 3 first. 3 8s are 24, 3 2s are 6, 84. So 84 into 15, 5 4s are 20, carry 2, 5 8s are 40, 42, 1 4s are 4, 1 8s are 8. So that will come to 0, 6 and 12. So 12 60 into 13, 3 0, 3 6 are 18, carry 1, 3 2 are 6, 7, 3 1s are 3, 1 0 0, 1 6, 1 2 are 2, 1 1 are 1. We add this 0, 8, 13, carry 1, 6, 1, 1 6 3 8 0, and because this minus into minus, this becomes plus, so this is 1 6 3 8 0. The previous one was negative, the answer was negative 1 2 6 0. And this one is positive 16,380. So with this we have completed our chapter on polynomials. I hope you have liked all the videos. please click on the like button if you have liked this video. Share it with your friends and classmates. Please subscribe to the channel and also click on the bell icon to be notified whenever new video is posted. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.